Let's see a little curiosity related to content items. And that will be content item handlers, or we could also say event handlers for content items. Because until now, we have done everything kind of directly with our content part, but we haven't talked about how you could actually run some code when some other content part runs, or run some code when just any arbitrary content types item is being updated, created, deleted, or whatever. And the example that we'll take a look at will be related to display text. Remember, we talked about display text, and we said that display text is pretty much like a generalized title for content items. So actually, when the title part is there on a content item, then it will set the display text. But the display text can come from anywhere. And why this issue is coming up to begin with is because we have a problem here. In our list, in the admin list for our previously created person page, we don't really have any kind of title. You see, it's just called person page, and we see that it has the content type person page, but if we have 50 person pages here, how can we distinguish between them? And that's an issue because we have actually specified the name. There is this John Doe. So we have data in this content item that kind of identifies it. We could display something that would let us know immediately which content item we are talking about. So we'll generate a display text for this content item from a handler. Let's see how that actually works. Now we'll go back to Visual Studio, and we'll create a handler, which is again kind of an event handler for content items, content parts. And where we put handlers commonly is in the handler's namespace. And I will now create a handler for our own content part, for person part, but you could similarly create handlers for other content parts, for whole content types, I mean, items of whole content types. So really, handlers are flexible content item related event handlers. But let's create now indeed for just person parts. And how we commonly name handlers like this is, well, like person part handler. And you may have guessed that we actually have a snippet for it here. So person part, and magically, oops, I managed to escape here, and magically we have everything here. A handler is just a class that, in case of a content part handler, has to derive from this content part, from this generic content part handler. But this is just a simplification. If we open this, you will see that what this is, this actually is an iContent part handler. And the iContent part handler is the one that contains all the events. As you can see, there are various events when a content item is created, when it is imported, updated. All the other steps in its life cycle removed. And commonly, these events are always in pairs. There is one event before the operation and after the operation. The one before the operation is called something ing, like removing async, and the event after the operation is called in the past tense, like removed async. But currently we'll use this content part handler base class as a simplification. And what we'll do here is that we'll set the display text when the content item is updated. So for that, we'll need to override overrides one of these methods. Well, in this case, we have to use updated because updating would run before the content item is actually populated from the new data that is saved from the editor. So if you want to use new data, of course, we'll need to use this. And here, in such event handlers, there's commonly some kind of context object, which, as you can see, is update context currently. And there is, in the case of content parts handlers, there is also always the targeted content parts instance. So we can set the display text. I just happen to know that in the context object, we have a content item property that contains the whole content item object. And of course, the display text property is up there. If we just set this at this stage, it will be also persisted. That's not universally true, but at this stage in the pipeline, we are at a step where we are before the whole content item being persisted. So we can just set the display text, and we can, for example, set it from the name of the person. We could also add the name and the birth date or something like that. This is a string, you can do whatever you like. And pretty much that's it. This is an async task, so we need this completed async, completed task. And of course, we shouldn't forget its registration. And there will be a bit of curiosity here as well, because again, this is a service related to a content part. So we have to use some kind of special registration. And let me format this a bit so the line won't be too long. And we actually have this @handler method for handler registrations. So a person part handler. And that's it. Let's go back to the editor, and once everything reloads and recompiles, let's see what happens. All right, the editor is here. Nothing changed in the list yet, because remember that this code runs when the content item is updated. So we have to resave our content item, and if everything goes right, in the content item list, we'll now see John Doe. So that's it. Very simple concept on its fundamental level. Handlers are event handlers for content items. So if you have any question that, okay, I want to run this when something happens with such a content item, you most possibly want to write a handler. There are similar event handlers, other event handlers in Orchard, for example, when user logs in or something like that. We'll take a look at these later.